Good afternoon, students. Today we will proceed on unit 5, selectors. We have already discussed in previous lecture what are selectors, what are the types of selectors. Okay, we have discussed full selectors and partial selectors, and in previous lecture we have discussed the Excel data automation. Okay, Excel data table automation. In this particular lecture, we will discuss PDF automation and email automation. Automation is the same that we have discussed from first lecture to till now. Automation means we have started to automate something. Here, for example, in previous lecture, we have automated the Excel data table. That means as an input, we have the data table, or we have an Excel file. We will provide that Excel file, and corresponding to the input and output variable or the different activities, at the end we will extract the information that is to be entered into the Excel sheet. In the same way, today we will discuss the PDF automation. Likewise, in this particular session, as an input we have the PDF document, and from that PDF document we will just extract the information. We have already discussed in previous lecture that extraction is an important feature of your RPA. While you are using the selectors, that particular information extraction will be required. Okay, with the help of the selectors you can extract the information from the various things like table, data table, Excel sheet, like PDF, like email. In the continuing of this series, in this particular lecture we will discuss PDF automation. We have already discussed what is automation. We have already discussed how the selectors are to be used to extract the information. So in this particular lecture we will directly start about the PDF automation. Okay, PDF may contain simple text or text in the form of images. Any kind of PDF document that you can imagine, that you have downloaded from the internet so many times, that PDF document may contain your text, may contain your images, or it may contain any kind of material, you can say that. With the help of the following step that I have already mentioned in this particular slide, we can extract the data from the PDF file and save them into a text file or show as message on screen. Okay. So start the PDF automation. First of all, again I am telling you, while starting the process of automation with the help of UiPath, our first step is to open the UiPath Studio and start a new blank project. Second step two, now put the PDF file from which you wanted to read the data. Okay, if you have remembered, in Excel data automation, first and second step are almost same. We have opened the UiPath Studio, then start a new blank process. There we have put the Excel file or Excel data table from which we want to read the data. Here we will put the PDF file from which we want to read the data in the folder of your current project. Okay, we are using like sample.pdf file for this particular example. Third one is the same, series is same, sequence is same. You will drag and drop a sequence into the designer panel. After drag and drop of the sequence into the designer panel, you will again drag and drop the read PDF text activity. This particular activity is helpful while it will retrieve the data or it will read the data from your PDF file. Okay, so for that you will use read PDF text. Drag and drop that read PDF text activity below the sequence in designer panel. It can be searched from the activity panel. I have already told you in previous lecture that activity can be found either in the activity panel or within the designer panel. There will be the plus symbol. You can click on that plus symbol, and at the top of that, each and every activity will be accessed. You can access each and every activity, right? Step 5 is, now we need to provide the path of the PDF file. Click onto the browse button. It will open the location of your current project where you have saved the PDF file. Which file? Sample.pdf that you have selected in step 2. Select that particular file. you will be shown in read PDF text. If you remember or if you think, you can see that each and every step is same as that of we have discussed in the Excel data table automation. Just in place of Excel data table, here PDF will use. Okay. Next is step 6. Now in the property of read PDF text activity, provide the name of output data table as a variable. The same thing we have already done in the previous topic. Okay. Right click into the data table text box and then click create variable. For example, we give it as read text output. We also need to provide the range of pages. By default, it would be set as all. But you can give the value in range like 1 to 3 pages. Okay. Otherwise, by default, it will extract all of the information that is to be entered or that is to be stored within the PDF document. It depends upon you. You want to retrieve the whole data or you want to retrieve a particular page data. It depends upon you. Okay. It will read first 3 pages, or you can also specify a particular page like 3. You simply specify 3, page number 3. In that case, that will only read page 3rd. Okay. Next step is, now we also want to write the output in text file. You want to retrieve the data, now you want to extract the data. While you extract the data, in that case, you required write text file activity. Okay. Under where? Read PDF text. You are doing read PDF, you are processing into the read PDF text. Now you want to retrieve the data. For that, you will want to write the output in a text file. You need to drag and drop write text file activity under read PDF activity. Next step, step 8. Now provide the name of the output file in double quotes. For example, we write output.txt. Also in the property of write text file activity, provide the name of the output text as variable, as we have done in step 6. It must be same provided in read PDF text activities output, that is read text output. You can see in this same slide that at step 6 there will be the read text output. Okay, it must be the same provided in read PDF text activities output, that is read text output. Final step, next step is step number 9. After getting the output, we want UiPath to display it. For this, we have to take a message box under write text file. The process is exactly same. Just instead of writing the table, you are writing the PDF. Okay. In the text box message, you will write the read text output. Read text output is what? This is what the you can say that the output text as the variable that you have created in step 6. Okay. Next is the final. The project will look like as this one. This is what the sequence is. You can rename the sequence. In previous example, if you have remind, in this read PDF that was written in sequence, but now it is written as read PDF. Read PDF means the name of the sequence you can change. You just simply click the mouse on this particular bar, and in property panel or in property window, you can change the name of the sequence. Okay. Instead of sequence, you can read the read PDF. Then read PDF text. This is the activity that you have drag and drop from the activity panel, and you will provide the sample.pdf. This is the file name that you want to extract the information from them. Okay. Then you will append the write text file and provide an output variable, that is output.txt. Okay. And you have provided the variable read text output. And finally, in message box, you have passed the read text output. With the help of this, the information that is to be stored into the PDF that can be extracted. It depends upon you what you have specified, the whole of the PDF or a particular range of the PDF or a particular page of the PDF. Okay. At step 11, when you will run the project, it will extract the PDF file and create a text file named output.txt, because this output.txt you have already mentioned where you want to extract the information into which file, and you have already provided the name output.txt and also given the output in message box like follow. Okay. The above example will only extract data from PDF file. But if that PDF file contains anything that you can use read PDF with OCR activity instead of read text, read PDF text. Okay. PDF automation is over. Now we will discuss the email automation. Here is some difference as we have discussed in data file, Excel file, or in the PDF automation. How we can do the email automation. In this, we deal with the reading of unread email from our Gmail account through UiPath Studio. The first step is same. You will follow these steps to perform the email automation. First step is same. What? You will open the UiPath Studio and start a new blank project. Second one is drag and drop a sequence in the designer panel. These two steps will be common in all the sequences, in all the automations what you want to do. Next one, third, drag and drop. In Excel data table, you drop scope application, Excel application scope. In PDF automation, you drop PDF automation, read text file, read PDF file. In third, you drag and drop, you will do the drag and drop get IMAP mail message. This is the activity that is to be present into the activity panel. You simply just search this particular activity and drag and drop that activity into the designer panel. Okay, activity below the sequence in designer panel, it can be searched from the activity panel. Step 4 is in the property of get IMAP mail message activity, provide the name of the server as imap.gmail.com and port as 993 under host. Also provide email address and password under login properties. Okay, login or logon properties, what you may call. Another thing we need to provide is the name of message under output property as variable. Right click in the data table text box and then click create variable, for example as the message. You can also select how many unread messages UiPath Studio should read by giving the number of in top priority under options. We choose 5 here, so it will read top 5 unread messages. Okay, step 5 is now what you want to do for each mail. For specifying that, we need to drag and drop for each activity. For each activity is means it is for the repetitions of all the 5 mails that you have to be, that you have already been selected. Okay, for each means first of all it will take first mail, then second, and up to so on till what the mails you have specified or what the count you have specified. It can be searched from activities provided here variable message which we used in step 4. We also have to change type argument to system.net.mail.mailMessage from property panel. It can be selected from browse for type option. Sixth step, now after getting the output we want UiPath to display it. For this we have to drag and drop message box under for each activity. In the text box of message box, write mail.subject, which means it will show only the subject of top 5 unread messages. That are other options also. There are other options also. The final projects will look like this. First of all, if this is the email, means this is what the sequence is. You have changed the sequence name as email. Then get IMAP mail messages. This is the activity that you have drag and drop from the activity panel, and you will apply the for each loop. In for each loop, for each mail in messages. Okay, whatsoever the number of messages you have mentioned, that like in our text, we have mentioned top 5 unread messages. In that case, mail in messages means mail is to be checked in that particular unread messages for up to 5 times. Okay, then the body, and finally in message box you have mentioned mail.subject. Okay, so this is all about the email automation. When you will run the above project, UiPath will show the message having the same things, that means your unread emails from the email ID you provided. This is all about your reference books. We have already discussed it. This is the online material you can find out from academy.uipath.com. Multiple times we have discussed this particular site. Okay, this is all about from the PDF automation as well as the email automation. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Otherwise, we will discuss the implementation part of this thing in the laboratory. Thank you so much.